Your thoughts on the NIL deals in college?
So it has been a revolution just in a year. And all of a sudden, it's expanded in ways that nobody ever really anticipated. First of all, it's not just quarterbacks for teams in football. It can go very deep. I mean, if you're in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, the 20th Alabama player might be interesting for somebody to work with. And what you've seen happen is the rise of collectives or consortiums of alums from different schools who have banded together to contribute money through their businesses to their specific school. So when they do that, it becomes a tool not simply for incumbent athletes, but in recruiting. So all of a sudden, what they didn't anticipate is that school X can tell a player in recruiting, we've got $5 million of NIL deals for you. And if the NCAA had only expanded the compensation a little more quickly, they could have avoided all this. But it changes our business because all of a sudden, instead of meeting Ike Taylor when you're a junior, or when you're a senior, all of a sudden it requires signing players out of high school to the next hot quarterback out of high school or the next hot DB out of high school. Because if another marketing agent signs that player who also represents athletes, if you don't sign them from high school, you would never get a chance to talk to them because if they're happy with who does the NILs. So it's
Wow.
changed everything. I mean, you have Jack in the Box giving 15 stipends to players with the first name Jack. I mean, you have all Phil Knight goes to Oregon and gives stipends to every single player. And depending on the alum wealth and the degree of excitement there is towards the team, it's just going to take the Power Five conferences and raise them to a completely disproportionate level.
Ooh.
I see you've got several clients listed on your portfolio as part of the new NIL rules, Lee. And I know the last time we talked to you, you told us about how your father instilled in you the importance of building relationships. What I'm curious about is what opportunities has that opened up for you personally now that you're able to represent and to work with college athletes?
So a lot of it's about branding. The currency of today is how many followers you have on social media. So the point is you would take a client and you have to take a look at what their website looks like, how they're what they're projecting as their image and likeness and potentially logo, and create a steady stream of posting on Instagram or TikTok or any Twitter or any of the social media. And so it has players branding themselves or the marketer in this case. So we are doing a running back at UCLA named Zach Charbonnet. And we negotiated a couple deals for him, but part of what we're working on is raising his profile. And so if an athlete posts enough and he has enough followers, that's a revenue stream that advertisers want to go to so they can monetize what's coming off of social media. So obviously it's totally different because now you have a high schooler thinking about what his brand is, how many people out of 100 can name that athlete. And if they can name him, can they put a positive adjectives together with them? And if they can do that, all of a sudden, and does he post interesting content? So it's a brave new world.